The GOP's deficit in the generic ballot poll score has spiked from just 3.2 points to 7.6 points in the last week as business donors and House Speaker Paul Ryan push for a wage-cutting amnesty. The new polls show all of the GOP's gradual gains since mid-March were suddenly wiped out starting June 1, when the Democrats held a mere 3.2-point advantage in the generic ballot, which records voters' partisan preference. One week late, on June 8, the gap had jumped to 7.6% as the establishment media extensively and favorably covered the discharge petition push and Ryan's June 6 public support for an amnesty. The GOP's score dropped 1.4 points, from 39.8%, during the week in comparison to prior polls by the same companies. The drop comprised 2 points in Fox polls, 1 point on The Economist's, YouGov polls, 5 points in the Reuters, Ipsos polls, 1 point in IBD/TPP polls and 1 point in Rasmussen polls. Democrats gained 3 points during the same week, so widening their advantage from 3.2 points to 7.6 points. For example, a June 6 report from Bloomberg described how energy investment has forced unemployment down to 2.1% in Midland, Texas, leaving employers no choice but to raise wages for Americans' voters because Trump is denying them easy access to additional illegals or immigrants. "Our goal is to not cut legal immigration," said Florida GOP Representative Carlos Corbello, who is a leader of the discharge petition group that is demanding the amnesty. Also, the number of illegals who get green cards from the amnesty should be as high a number as possible, Corbello told RollCall.com on June 8. The number of young illegal immigrants in the United States is estimated at up to 3.6 million. Amnesty advocates use business-funded pollsters to conduct Nation of Immigrants push polls which show apparent voter support for DACA amnesty, for immigration, and immigrants. Those pollsters also push their clients' preferences when they advise their political clients. But choice polls reveal most voters often ignored strong preference that CEOs should hire Americans at decent wages before hiring migrants. Those pro-American preferences are held by many blue-collar blacks, Latinos, and by people who hide their opinions from pollsters. Similarly, the 2018 polls show that GOP voters are far more concerned about migration, more properly, the economics of migration, than they are concerned about illegal migration and MS-13, taxes, or the return of Representative Nancy Pelosi.